Hi, I'm Heather. I'm one of the systems engineers here at Pessler. This tutorial is about auto discovery with auto discovery groups. So let's go take a look. Before we jump into looking at the auto discovery groups, I do want to talk for a few minutes about templates because they do go hand in hand. A template is a collection of sensor settings that you can apply later to a device or a group of devices. So, for example, I come in here to my Windows server with my WMI settings, and I already put my device in. My device here is called System, and I already have all of the sensors that I want to use for that. Now, say I want to tweak some of my sensor channel settings. So here, let's click on the CPU load sensor. I don't like how I have these sensor channel limits, so let's change those just a little bit, because I want them to, I want to be my upper hour limit. Let's put that at 75. And my warning, I don't want it at 50. Let's just do this one at 65. So I changed that channel limit. And now those channel limits will be in my template once I create my template. And creating a template is quite easy. So now that I have all of my sensors with the sensor settings in there, I right click on my device and I say, create device template. You're going to give it a name. I'm going to call this base Windows WMI. You can make the file name and the template name the same thing. So I'm going to just copy and paste right in there. Now, I know you probably want to go and you see checkboxes at the bottom and feel the need to go check things because they're there. That's what most people do. But please pay attention here when you're creating a template, that when you check these boxes, it's to exclude these sensors from your template. I've many times customers come to me and say, my sensors are never in the template. And I say, did you check the box? And they did. For this particular template, I don't want my Windows Update Status sensor in there. So I'm going to check it to exclude it, but I want everything else. We're going to say OK, and my template has been created. So say now I take another device and I want to apply that template. I can just right click on it. You go auto discovery, run auto discovery with template. It just lets you see what templates are in here. We do have a bunch of templates out of the box as well. And you can see my base WMI template is in there. I can click on that and then add that. Though for in this particular case, it might add that, it won't remove the sensors that are there. So you can see it says auto discovery in progress. It will additionally add my WMI sensors to my SNMP device right there. But if you had deleted them or you have a blank device, it will apply the new template. You'll know in another minute why we talked about templates once we jump into auto discovery groups. So auto discovery is really important because sometimes you just need an automated way to add your devices quickly without doing it one by one manually. So to do so, we come to the blue menu up here and just select add auto discovery group. I'm going to give my auto discovery group a name after I pick the probe. I'm going to do this on my data center remote probe. Say okay. And I'm going to just call the new group. We'll just name it Heather's Auto Discovery Group. And again, I need to spell correctly, but my fingers are freezing. Put the group name in here. Now, once we go under the group type, this is why we talked about templates. We do our sensor management. You have three options here. You could do automatic device identification, standard recommended, and let PRTG decide. We have automatic device identification detailed, may create many sensors, and that's true. He will have many, many sensors. And then you could do automatic sensor creation using a specific template, and all of our out-of-the-box templates are in here, plus our new ones as well. But right now, we're going to just let PRTG do it. We come down for discovery schedule. You could see we could do it once, hourly, daily, or weekly. For the most part, you're going to want to leave it at once, because once you auto-discover something, you don't want to keep doing it. It's going to add to the overhead of your PRTG server if you're constantly, especially hourly, having auto-discovery run. Now, sometimes if you say, well, what if I want to catch new devices on my network? What I would recommend is, after you do your initial auto-discovery, have that all populated, then maybe make a blank group to discover stuff later, maybe daily or weekly to catch rogue devices, and then you can move them to static groups later. So for now, I'm going to leave this at once. Now here's how you select what goes into the audit discovery group. You could do a Class C IP address with a start and end, and you could see here, if I would do that, I would put my base here in my start and end range. A list of individual IPs and DNS names, you could do that. You could do an IP in a subnet, an IP with an octet range as well. You could do the list of individual ones with IPv6, or you can use computers from Active Directory. So you can actually point an Active Directory OU and have auto discovery run from there. So what I'm going to do right now is just do two individual IP addresses to save in the course of time. So I'm going to do and then you just put them in a row. This is handy sometimes too if you have a spreadsheet already or some sort of report that you can copy and paste your IP addresses in or DNS names. Now you can come down here for name resolution. You can use DNS names, and for DNS, we use the DNS settings that's already on your PRTG server, or you can use just IP addresses if you don't care about DNS names. If you need to change any of your credentials, you can uncheck these at the bottom. If not, it will inherit it from above. I'm going to say OK right now, and it's going to start. So now that is my new group. Let's scroll to the bottom of my probe, and you can see the auto discovery is in progress right now. It does take a few minutes because you have to remember PRTG in the meantime, it's still pulling all your devices at the regular intervals and ranges. And now you can see that this auto discovery group is populated with the two devices, and PRTG is discovering the sensors and choosing which sensors to pick with it. So now that you know about templates and auto discovery groups, you could go ahead and start populating your device tree with devices and sensors. Thank you for watching this tutorial. We have many others on our website. And if you have any other questions, please contact us at support@pestler.com. If you find this video helpful, feel free to like it and consider watching our other videos on our channel. If you still have questions, please contact support@pestler.com. And always feel free to comment for feedback or suggestions for other topics. Thank you.